online is part of what we refer to as the digital presence. Apart from that, it is an existence of an individual or business that can be found by an online search. At times when you are looking at online, you discover that digital presence is part of the way the company appears online. When you go out to check the company, or you even go out to check your personal self, it will tell you how you are, how the company is online. That's what we mean by digital presence. Your presence online. That's what we mean by digital presence. Are you getting it, please? So now, apart from that, we look at digital presence in terms of definition. We also want presence to say that you have to be here now. That means you are doing it now. When people need you, they have you. When if someone needs your CV, if you need my information now, as I'm seated, though I'm in class, if you go online, you get my everything about me that is relevant to what you need. And that's what we mean by digital presence. It's creating powerful presence. You'll be excited to know, you'll be excited that someone is waiting for you online. It's something that will definitely excite you. And that's what digital presence is. It's about another thing is this: in digital presence, you have to know yourself and grow yourself. I will have to explain this. When you know yourself in the digital world, don't stop at knowing yourself. You have to grow yourself. When we say grow yourself, what do you mean? You have to develop yourself. The state at which you started is not the state you should be limited or restricted to. So that's why we talk about you growing yourself in the digital world. Presence, of course, within the moment. So this growing yourself, as you are now, we gave you a pre-class activity where you submitted your LinkedIn page and what have you, and I've been able to check some of you up from your submission. But you discover that some people, the last time they appeared online, maybe 4 years ago, that when I say appeared, you see, when you talk about digital presence, it goes beyond I'm using WhatsApp. That's not digital presence. Do you understand? That does not give you any recognition as much as possible. For most of us, it's just waste of time. We are just wasting our time. You understand? And we are not really achieving anything special. And that is the limitation about digital presence. Please just a minute at it. You know yourself, you grow yourself. Presence occurs within the moment. Then you have to harness self-awareness and inner wisdom. But before I really go into all those areas, there is this idea I was explaining about the issue of growing yourself. If you want to grow yourself, you have to develop your online presence. Don't be limited by what you did last year or what you did even last month. You should update yourself, grow yourself regularly. In the physical world, as you grow, in the digital world, you must also grow. And nobody will know you are growing if you are not reporting your growth. That's why you have to know yourself. Know yourself is talking more of the issue of identifying who you are, your niche, and your specialty. Then you grow yourself. I normally say this, that it's not how old you are, but how grown you are. So those are the things that you are going to be following and you are going to be doing in the digital world. So you have to grow yourself. Some people, if you look at it, they just remain stagnant in the digital world. that such a person is not having a good recourse in the aspect of his digital presence. Now let's move on to the features and the importance of digital presence. It helps you to have more opportunities as you are easy to be found on LinkedIn or on Google. You understand? That's what digital presence helps you to do. Then it helps to tell your story the way you want it told. You see, at times, I have had reports as an ICT professional of people that they have negative reports about them. They are like, wow, this is not the truth about it. Well, the only way you can get the truth is to follow the digital presence. You understand? Because in the digital presence will help you. You can use it to actually write. You can use it to actually do things you want to do. Are you getting me now? And that's what digital presence does. So you have to get this very, very well. Because a lot of people don't understand how serious digital presence is, and they just do things haphazardly. Such things will not work, and such things are not actually productive. So what you do is to work on your digital presence the more, you work on your performance the more, and definitely you are going to get very good results. So websites and social media platforms are excellent marketing tools. Now, what does that mean? When you look at digital presence, your website, social media platforms, you use them to market. And as I've told you times and again, a lot of people are now getting wiser with the use of their digital presence. That is why you see that they use their social media platform to sell their products and not just ordinary waste of time and family displays. You understand? Cost-effective methods of sending out information to thousands of people. For this program to hold, you know, there's only a single poster only a single poster was made, and that poster, the poster was sent around. If it had been for the physical world, we would have made handbills, different handbills would have been made, and we would have to give it out to as many people as we want to attend the program. So digital presence helps you in that area. You can pass your information. The another issue is as many people as possible can visit your LinkedIn, can visit every different aspect of your social media platform without you losing anything. It's a single CV you have put online, and that is what you have that remains online with you. You understand? Digital presence also has a huge influence on the way consumers make purchasing decisions. A lot of people that want to eat something, they want to buy something, they want to even engage you. You understand? Your digital presence matters a lot. When they check you online, do we have any information about you? What are we going to get about you? And that is what we talk about digital presence. You will remember that I've explained to you what digital opportunities are. You have opportunities to do this and that online, but now we are getting to the level of your presence in the digital world. Now, how do you have your digital presence? One of the key things in having digital presence is the issue of your digital branding. Now, digital branding is about establishing your brand story and presence. You know, if you have a meeting and you know someone has a car, maybe uses a white car, if you get to the garage, to the garage and you see the car park rather, and you saw the car there, you know definitely that person is around. That's a brand. He's marked himself with that brand. If he doesn't have a car, but you know he's always putting on white shoe. If you get to the venue of the meeting and maybe everybody has put up their shoe outside and you saw a white shoe there, you know definitely that person is inside. So when we talk about branding, the perception of people about you, what people know, you know, we have digital branding. Digital branding starts from your look. Some of you don't understand the meaning of digital branding. That's why you will look different on Facebook, different on LinkedIn, and another picture on the Twitter. If you are trying that, you are affecting your digital branding. These are things that end up affecting us without us knowing, and we just do things haphazardly. You see, in digital branding, your look is very key. Your look is key. What type of look are you going to have? Well, if you are an imam, for example, you cannot be putting on jeans And you say it doesn't matter. Everything matters because digital branding will give us a type of look. If you are an engineer, it should reflect your look. Your look should speak it. Because you see, the platform in the digital world is not meant for any other thing, more than to sell yourself. You are there to promote yourself. You are there to sell what you have. If you are an intellectual, you are an academician, if you are you render services, and the services is based on your CV, then you display that, because it's based on that that they are going to give you contract. Nobody's going to give you contract because you have 1 million children, because you have 20 cars. Nobody's going to consider that. So those are not the things you are expected to start caring about. Some of us, that's what we do. Every month, every week, we upload different pictures of family members. That's not what is expected of us in the digital presence. Now you understand. Another issue is, I'm talking about identity. Visibility, of course, you must be visible. Now, the issue of identity, there's something else I'm going to explain to you, and that's the idea of your name. You see, if you look at my name now, Dr. Dayo Sobowale, you see, it's a brand. You have to, you should know your brand. Dayo Sobowale, I am Ade Dayo, but the brand, after attending the class on personal branding, I got to understand that Shola Shonoiki, Yemi Oshibaji, you see that? Wale Shoyinka. So you see the trend. It's a brand. You understand? It's easy to pronounce. You have your first name, you have your surname. Are you getting the concept now? And with that, you are known. It's a brand. So you need to consciously seek your brand, the name you will call. And some of us don't really understand the importance of this branding. And that is how you discover that we just pick up any name. And I have told you, if your Twitter handle, your Instagram, your LinkedIn, your Facebook page, your email address, all these things should reflect that name. Don't be Dayo Sobowale somewhere, then you are David Sobowale in another place. You're going to be causing confusion. In digital branding, consistency is key. Consistency is key. So you have to understand that. Another issue is credibility. And this is why you have to be very careful when you are talking about online issue. Online issue, you don't get online and you are there, and then you are now misrepresenting yourself. How do I mean? You see, if in the physical world, if someone steals in a particular state, the person runs to another state, and it starts a new life. But that is not possible in the digital world. In the digital world, it's only one state, is the universe. So anything about your name is there. You are going to be learning it very shortly. So because of that, you must be careful in terms of credibility. This is very, very important. Let me take you to the next stage, and you look at how to create a digital presence. I want to quickly go through this as I'll be coming back to you. So now, what are the 6 ways to build your digital presence? Number one, share your passions. My brethren, you have listened to me. Your interests, your passions, the things that move you. If I ask you a question from the way you have been seeing me take this class, do you think I am passionate about this class? Do you think I'm passionate about what I'm teaching? Do you think I believe in it? You understand? The same way, what you are passionate about is what you should share. You see, a lot of people, when they have their blog, they want to get involved in so many things. And that's why in the long run, they get involved in nothing. You share your passions. Your interests are what help people to get to know you. The reason why you are in my class, I don't even know some of you. You understand? It's because of my interest, my passion. Oh, you have been told by someone that you need to listen to one young man who has passion for this issue of digitalization. He will be able to explain to you and teach you appropriately. And that's what we are doing here. Passion, passion, passion. Share your passions. Your interests are what help people to get to know you. If you want to be known, it has to do with your So you understand what I'm saying? So you have to share your passions. You have to share your passions, your interests. Then you find your niche. What's your area of strength? Find your niche. Make sure your online presence is unique and stands out from any potential competition. Let me tell you something about this aspect of sharing or finding your niche. When you talk about your passion and your niche will go together. A lot of people will come into online job. This is the most difficult aspect. Without understanding their area of peculiarity, without settling down to know what exactly am I good at. And you see, they think, I've explained that and I've clarified it. But digitalization is not about computerization. They are two different things. Digitalization is pouring your content to the countries. Digitalization is taking your content from your compound down to the country. That's digitalization. Digitalization will offer you a platform to showcase your potential to the people. And by the time you want to showcase that potential, it's not only your potential, it's also for you. Digitalization is a platform for you to spread your passion. Am I being heard? What do I say about that? Can someone help me type what I just said? That digitalization is a platform for you to share your passion. Digitalization is a platform for you to share your passion. So if you don't identify your passion, if you don't identify your area of strength, then you are not going to get it. You understand? The way you want it to be. So your interest, that's what will get people to know you. That is what will give you an edge over others. Find your niche. Make sure your online presence is unique. Don't just be where everybody is. Be unique in your own area. Then another thing is you have to build a website. If you have a business, you need a website. If you don't have a business, you need a blog site. Let me clarify that. It's either a website or a blog site. You have to build something. You understand? And definitely, as you build it, you see that things move. You build a professional brand. You should be known with something unique. You should be known with a unique area. You should be known with something that is special. And that is exactly what is expected of you in the digital world. So apart from that, you see that you have to still keep some level of privacy. I'll be explaining that to you as we move ahead. Now, how do we create digital presence? If you want to create digital presence, one of the ways to build an email list, you have to master search engine optimization. You have to create value. Now, this creation of value is talking about your value system. It's talking about what you are doing. It's talking about what you are contributing. It's talking about what you are adding to the digital world, because that's what Google will pay you for. If you are not doing what is new, if you are just doing what any other person has done, if you are just a copycat, then you are not adding value. In academics, we call it contribution to knowledge. If you aren't contributing to knowledge, then Google isn't going to pay you for nothing. Do you understand? So you have to be active online. And being active online, you are going to be getting it in the next phase of the topic, which is digital footprint. Analyze your results. Adopt new forums. And of course, again, you make a website. What are the ways? Set your goals. This is something I need to explain to you from what we have been discussing all along. When you talk about setting your goals, I need to plead with you and explain to you that you have to understand one fact. And the fact you have to understand is that for you to set your goals, you must know what you are going for. Are you going for money? Of course, digitization can give you money. It will definitely give you money. But before then, you might be going for relevance. I have, okay, is that a question or something? Did I just apply? Thank you so much. I am very grateful, Mrs. Kolawole. You understand? Yes, it's a platform to showcase your passion. Thank you so much for giving me that, for giving that to me. Now, by the time you look at it, you will discover that digitalization requires you to set your goals. You must know your goals. What exactly are you getting involved with? And that is what we talk about, your goals. I discovered that most people that come into digitalization without having their goals set, they end up missing out. And that's the thank you. So we have the issue of setting your goals. So when you are setting your goals, you have to confirm something. The first thing is you need to have a presence. When you have a presence, you have value, you have relevance. It's after that you can now make money in the digital world. If those things are not there, making money in the digital world will be a mirage expected it to be. So that's something that is very important and very, very germane. So you need to set your goals in the digital world. Set your goals before you get there. Set your goals before you begin to do anything in the digital world. And a lot of people, they don't know what to do. They don't know how to do it. They don't know what to follow. Are you getting it? Take, for example, if you look at it, If you have set your goals, someone like me now, when it comes to mentality and reality, I'm going to show you later in class today, is an area I want to take charge of in the world. And that's why you see that I keep writing along that line and people keep making comments. And also in the area of digitalization, I want to seriously make my mark. So you need to be careful and you need to be aware of the fact that you need to make your mark, and you should know how you are making your mark. So now, you apart from that, you have to be consistent. As I want someone to give me that in typing, be consistent. You must be consistent and create value. Digitalization requires a lot of discipline. If you are publishing, you have to be consistent. Like now, if I can't publish tomorrow, by Tuesday morning, I must publish. You understand? You have to be consistent because people will be reading you. They want to know, are you going to be publishing every Tuesday? You want to publish every Thursday? And that's how they'll be reading you in the digital world. Yes, someone has given me something. Thank you so much, Sister Ronke. Be consistent. Be consistent. Be consistent. It's something that is highly required in the digital world. Now, what are the platforms for you to perform in the digital world? One is you need Twitter. You need Twitter. You need LinkedIn. You need Facebook. Apart from that, you need email, you need video channels, you need all this to perform well in the digital world. I also, thank you so much, engineer. You have to be consistent. Thank you for that. You understand? So you need all this. Apart from that, you need a blog site. For most of us here who are in academics, those of us, I have some librarians here, you need to be consistent. And you need a blog site because that is where your opinions can be expressed to the world. A lot of people don't understand this. Apart from the journals where we publish for promotion, another thing that is required is your personal contribution to the world. Thank you so much, my HOD, sir. So you understand. So you see that you have to be consistent. So now by the time you are talking of what you do with a blog site, you can now have your name. You can be known. We are going to see that very shortly because we have a lot of things to learn. So let's move on to getting that done. Knowing your digital presence, I was able to check for some of us. There is a doctor in the house who is my senior colleague in the legal profession, but I've not seen him. Okay, he's here to join us now. I'm expecting to join us very shortly. I went to check his digital presence. Dr. Barrister Musbah Latif. Now checking in, I have Alhaji Barrister Chief Dr. Abdul Latif Kilani here, and that's not him. You understand? You see, despite the fact that he's a lecturer, he's been involved in a lot of paper presentation in OAU and what have you still discover that this aspect, he has not written much. You understand? Maybe he doesn't have a presence on LinkedIn and what have you, and those things are now affecting him. Now, if you now check for your appointed counsel, now this is not him, and those are things that limit one. So I went ahead and I checked someone else. When it comes, I'm still going to bring that back because of our time. I checked Sister Ronke. Sister Ronke, you are the librarian of Lee City University, Ibadan. And that's what you have on LinkedIn. Your LinkedIn is what brought you here, your LinkedIn page. Now, you see, by the time you look at this, I have some of you in class now, but because of time, because I want to round off this class by 8, because of time, I did not check some of you. I did not report some of the things I saw. But you see that what I have here about Sister Mrs. Ronke Olurayi is something that has to do with her performance at her job. You understand? It's not talking about what she has been doing in some other places. And that's why if you look at her picture, if you look at the picture, you discover that by the time you... Let me quickly show that. Can you see this? Now, this is the place that to show a picture. Can you see this? Now, Sister Ronke, is this you? This is not you. This is not you. Is this you? Can you give me a reply? Type something. I need your reply. Is this you? Okay. Please help me confirm, Dr. Latif. Can you imagine? So that shows that your digital presence is very low. Your digital presence. This is your name. Now, is this you? Is this you, Sister Ronke? Or this? Let me pick one. This one I'm putting my hands on. I guess this is you. This one is showing LinkedIn. I'm still waiting for your reply. Thank you. Thanks for that. Now, you see that if you check, now this is your page. Other people are taking your pictures space. Aha, thank you, ma. So, ma, you have a lot of work to do on your digital presence. Can you see? You have a lot. Look at the people that are, look, when they brought your name, a man is showing here. And that man should not be there at all. The man should not be there at all. Let's look at Engineer Dipo Alani. Engineer Dipo is in class. Alani, let's look at the digital presence. We want to check your digital presence. We want to see what you are doing. Dipo Alani. Sir, is this you, this first one? This you, am I right? Let me see your answer. Okay, now, but this is not you. I want you to be seeing that. This is you, this is not you. Now you can see that your presence in the digital world, you have not taken charge of your name. A lot of people are fighting you for your name. This is the analysis that is being given about you. People are learning food and, okay, I guess this is OCBC. environmental question engineer, Oshun the child to help check me. So it is the issue of Oshun that brought your name up, engineer Dipo. Is the issue of your website of Oshun along with the permanent secretary was the flood control that happened. You are one of the people that worked on it, and that is what is giving you that presence. Now, if you look at this man that is already dead, Oladipo Dia, he is still here now. Yes, I think Dipo Dia is not dead, if I'm not mistaken, before I go and say something wrong online. So now this old soldier is still there. So when you talk about your name, your link, the issue in Oshun that you helped, that you worked on, was what brought your name out, flood and drainage control. Are you getting it now? So your digital presence is low. Let's look at Dr. Tayo Olaniyan. I have checked that today. Now, Olaniyan, Nigeria Adaptation Consultant, can you see? That's someone else. That's not you. That person has more digital presence than you. Now, Google Scholar Citation is what brought your name out. Doctor of Computer Science and Engineering. You see that? That was what brought your name out. So, Dr. Emolani, Advanced Computer Engineering, Senior Lecturer and Acting Head. And this one is bringing your name out because you are a member of Federal University or Yeikiti. You understand? So, and that is the issue. Now, if you look at the area of your picture, so your digital presence is very, very low. Your digital presence is very low. Have we been joined by Barrister? Not yet. So now if you look at this, you see it now. Your digital presence, you know, because I know you, I've not seen your picture. You see the people that are taking over your name. Even a woman is coming before you. Just imagine. You understand? You see it now. Your picture is not even here. The Google does not know you as the real Olaniyan. Now you have to fight for your digital presence. You just have to fight for it. You are seeing it. When we talk about digitalization, it will take frantic effort. And that is what we are seeing now. So please, you have to work on it. You cannot check your presence the more at all. Onyekachi, I tried checking yours too. I didn't get anything. That's why I didn't bring you up here. Your digital presence is not reflecting anything about you, Onyekachi. So, and that is why I said we all have lots of work to do. We have lots and lots of work to do in terms of our digital presence. So you are seeing it now. You are seeing the importance. So now the next thing we'll be doing now is let us go ahead and check. Just a minute. Let me bring up a new share. Digital presence. So that's that. Now look at mine. Okay, let me show you mine even from that last page, Doctor. So that you get what we are talking about, Doctor Dayo Shobo Wale. You see your digital presence. Can you see what I am saying here? Now, Doctor Dayo Shobo Wale, you can see this. So already you are seeing what. Oh wow, this is even wonderful. You see that? Name for me, You see that? You see different performances, growing mentality. You see it now. So this is how you have to block your name. This was when I wished the Muslims Eid Mubarak. You understand? So you see the stuff. This was my birthday. Understand? So this is what I wrote about education. Do you understand? Oshun-based education is that Shobo Ali. Do you understand? That's what I've been doing each time I write. You see it now. It's recognized. It's giving attention, and of course, you now see that. You see the later part. This later part, you can see Shola Shobo Ali coming up. There, you understand. Initially, when I check my digital presence, if you write my name, it will bring Shola Shobo Ali's picture. Today, I have taken over. You see it now. Please stay ahead. This is what I was looking for. Can you see that? Oshun today, that Shobo Ali initiative. Take over. I have taken over. Do you understand? You write more about yourself, you grow your digital presence. That's the only way for you to remain known. That's the only way for you to remain known. You must find a way to be known. And the way is to have, nobody will blow your trumpet for you. You cannot sit down and be expecting one miracle to happen somewhere. This is me as a blogger. You understand? My blogging page, as a YouTuber. My YouTube page is also being reflected. So that's what we are talking about. You must take over. You see it now. Everywhere my picture attached to your name. Don't allow anybody to take off your name. And that's what we talk about when we say digital presence. So I've shown you here. In fact, the taking over I have is even more than what I'm showing you here. So please work on yourself. Now, benefits of LinkedIn. Oh, a lot of people will check you. You can even get job you did not pick for. Because when you are on LinkedIn, you have a lot of people who can easily look out for you. And they will be like, wow, let's hear from him. Let's know him. And of course, they will give you jobs that you might not have bargained for. And why would they give you such jobs? Because they will check your profile. And once they see your profile, you see that you'll be added up. And that's the issue of profile, the issue of presence. Now, LinkedIn has, of course, please, you have to be on LinkedIn. It's professional. You have to be on LinkedIn. Let's move on. Features of digital branding. What can help you, your company? Like my HOD, the fact that you work with Federal University of Ekiti brought up your name. That's the organization you work for. Then you have to be, then the same thing happened to Engineer Dipo Alani, that brought up your name. You have to be careful, your professional body, you are an engineer, pay them, you are a lecturer, you are a lawyer, you pay, and the association, as the name of the association is recognized, your digital presence will also be recognized. So also is the issue of a website, and most importantly is blog site. You need blog site. You cannot dodge it. You need blog site. You need something that is germane, you work on and you follow. Then is the let's look at your personality. Your personality, or you have to grow it. And how do you grow it? Social media platforms. What people see about you, what they see about you. Now go through this, I'll be explaining. So Now you need a business blog, social media, email marketing. You need all these things. Please, you cannot but have them. You cannot but have them. You cannot but have them. And that's why I'm trying to explain to you that you have to build this. Another thing you need to understand in getting is the issue of LinkedIn. Take a look at this, for example. If you can see this page, it said, if you look at this this aspect, you see that it says one works at Chevron. Some people viewed my profile. You understand? Yeah, three work at Federal University of Yekiti. That is what you begin to see. People will be checking your profile and they will begin to know you more. Do you understand? And digital presence, that's how it helps you. It will just help you because people will get to know. So those are the things you need to understand about digital presence. Now, another issue I want to show you is this issue of your pictures. Look at this picture. When you see this young man here, you don't need to be told that this man is a speaker. You understand? You see that the picture shows that he's speaking. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. And that is why you must understand how to, the type of picture you use. If you go back to my pictures, let me quickly show you again online. You'll see that most of them, you can see with a mic, are you getting it? It's about speaking. It shows speaking. You understand? This shows the legal profession. This one I was in court. Do you understand? So you see that your picture should tell us what you do, who you are. You see that? Speaking. Why do we do this? It gives you a brand, and that is what people see about you. And that is what they will follow about you. Please, it's very important. Are you seeing that? Now, the purpose of digital presence, you need digital presence. You need to have digital value. Then you have digital frequency. These three, when they combine, it will give you digital footprints. And when you have your digital footprint, which is the next topic I'll be talking on, you will have digital dominance. And once you have dominance, people will start asking for you, come and design this for us. Come and design this for us. And of course, it is after then you begin to have your digital profit. Now, I'll be taking you straight to the next thing, which is the digital footprint. Which is the digital footprint. Let me quickly open the digital footprint, so that every one of you can see it and be part of it. So we are going to be going through the digital footprint now. You will be able to learn more about how to communicate in the digital world. Digital footprint is something that is very, very important. In fact, each time I'm opportune, can you hear that word? Each time I'm opportune to teach it, I'm always careful how I teach it, because is something that you need to, it's a mind changer, and you discover that everything you do, it's almost rounded. And that is why digital footprint needs a lot of attention. I believe you are still in class. Now, I'll be taking you on digital footprint. That's the next topic I'll be considering with us. Now, you see, the first thing is you have to understand there are facts and there are myths. There are facts about digitalization, there are myths, there are lies about digitalization. And these two, I will start from that point. What are the facts about digitalization? Now, it's as if I'm going over some of the things you have learned before, but I want you to follow me. I want you to be actively involved in this. This is one of the topics I don't toy with. I don't toy with this topic at all because it's very important. It's very, very germane. Digital footprint is something you cannot but listen to. Now, by the time you are looking at this, digital footprint, you must have a niche. Can someone help me type niche? Help me type niche, 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 niche. Let me see you type niche. Everybody in the house, type niche. Let me see you type niche. Yes, I'm reading. That's good. I think we're in class now. Niche. Yes, thank you so much. Let me read from others. Niche. Thank you so much. Okay, Raphael, thank you. Now, thank you, Ma. Now, when you talk about a niche is your area. I've told you initially when I was explaining, I explained to you that when you talk about niche, you are talking of the area you love, the area you are good at, and what have you. But the second aspect of a niche, you are talking about the area of your peculiarity in the digital world. One, you can be a developer, you can be a vendor, you can be a content writer. As a developer, I am a programmer and a developer. You understand? That's my niche. You understand? That's in terms of professionalism. But in terms of communication, you see that I communicate, I write, I'm a writer. That's a content writer, content developer. It's not everybody that can write. And you know some companies, they will pay you. In fact, as a matter of fact, I have some people that are already negotiating with me that I should write and they pay me on a monthly basis. So you can be a trainer, and that's what I'm doing now. You must have a niche. If you have some PhD students or master students and as an academician, you create something for them, you begin to train them. It's not compulsory, the ones that are attached to you. The ones attached to you in your school, you may not be able to collect any money from them. But if you throw out a research program and anybody is free to attend, they will attend, you will train them. And what do you use? You use the same method. You need to have your niche. Then another issue is originality. Originality is loaded with who am I, that's who you are, your gifting, your strength, your potentiality, your passion. You have to combine all these things. Originality tweaks about three things: your professionalism, your passion, your potential, and equally your person. That's talking about four. That's originality. You have to establish who exactly are you. You need that identity. Then, what are the facts about digitalization? You must be consistent. As a blogger, you want to blog twice a week, once a week, once in 2 weeks, fortnightly. That's what you have to think of. But it's usually advisable you do it weekly. Another thing is you have to be patient. Relax. It's not going to happen overnight. It will take time. It's not going to happen. It will take time. Then finally, on this, in this regard, you must not lie so that you can last. Don't lie so that you can last. I wish you could help me type that. It's an area I'm always interested in. Don't lie so that you can last. For you to last in the digital world, you must not lie. Don't go online to tell us who you are not. It's going to affect you very seriously. Don't lie so that you can last. That is the cry in the digital world. Don't lie so that you can last. Don't tell lies so that you can last. And that's why you have to work on yourself. Yes, thank you so much. Don't lie so that you can last. Yes, I'm happy. Let me read more from you. Don't lie so that you can last. Because if you look at it, if you lie, you won't last. If you lie, you won't last. That's the truth. So to last, don't lie. In the digital world, tell us who you are. Don't tell us who you are not. Because I've explained to you that the limitation in the digital world is mental limitation. It's not physical limitation, but rather mental limitation. Don't lie so that you can last. That is germane. That is key. That is important. If you lie, thank you so much, Engineer Dipo Alani. I love the way you put it. If you lie, you won't last. That's it. So you to last, don't lie. Oyekachi, thumbs up for you. I love that rephrasing. So these are the things you have to take note of in the digital world. Now, what are the materials you need in the digital world? All the materials you need, hardware, of course, you need your Android phone. Android phone is more friendly. iPhone is usually limited because of the operating system. So I advise you buy Android phone. Please don't use phone for 1, 2, 3 years. And you say it is strong. Once there's a new network, once there's a, the moment 5G comes out, don't wait. We let the first 1 month go so that they can test run. After that, go and buy a 5G compliant phone. You must be compliant. The elderly ones among us, please, I will advise use tablet. You can see this elderly man is online with his tablet. It will help your eyes. Another thing is, oh, you can't toy with laptop. For the children, for yourself, you actually need to get a laptop. There's software application. Those of us who are into programming, you see that we have block programming, web programming, portal, a lot of things like that. Those of us who are into programming, we have that, and that is what we do. Don't lie so that you can last. I keep saying that, and of course, I want it to sink. Now, apart from that, what are the required skills for the digital world? What skills do you need? First thing is thinking capacity. Are you typing that? Let me see you typing. Thinking capacity. Thinking capacity. Thinking capacity. Your thinking capacity must be germane. You see, you must be able to think. When you are talking of rape case is trending now, you should be able to think out of the box. You understand? Thinking capacity. Thank you so much. You must be able to think out of the box. Don't come and write about rape the way every other person will write. We write. As look at Madam Ronke Olurayi. You are a Liberian. How can we cure rape through books? Do you understand? Look at the student that was killed in Benin. If that student was in the library, we should have been killed. She would not have been killed because she was not in the library. She went to read. They have traced that program. They know that that's where she goes regularly. When you write, your thinking capacity should reflect that you are very, they say some people are cerebral. Oh boy, that's how you should be. You are brilliant. You have the brain. Your thinking capacity, and you will not just write any jargon. By the time some people write, you just look at it, you'll be wondering, where is this person coming from? And you know the reason is because they have not developed their thinking capacity. You cannot have a blog and begin to write what every other person writes. You must write uniquely. You must write specially. And that is what will make a name for you and make a way for you. Phone manipulations. Don't run away from manipulating phones. And what? How do I mean? When some of us buy phones, apart from WhatsApp and Facebook, there is nothing we can do with the phone. That's wrong. Learn how to use the voice note. Learn how to use Zoom. Someone will tell you, I don't know how to use Zoom. I've not used it before. Where would I click? Learn how to do graphics. Graphic design. Of course, everybody in this class, you have started graphics. After this class, we are still going to report back to complete our graphics class. Then you'll be giving assignments. You'll be completing your graphics class today. Then you'll be given assignments to continue. You understand? So that's what will happen. Professional skills, your content development skills, your written English. Your written English. It's not only your spoken English, your written English. When I say content development, imagine when you came on board. If I started saying, when I was coming, I told them to come. How are you going to cope? Wouldn't you have left? You would have left. You would have said, you don't understand how that man is speaking English that way. Now, what type of English is he speaking? You see, your content development, you must be sound grammatically. You must build yourself. Better grammar is your friend. It takes discipline. It takes the skills. That's why I tell people, digitalization, it requires more discipline than computerization. Oh, it requires a lot of discipline. And that is what we have. Now, what are the challenges of digitalization? Is digitalization all free? The answer is no. Does it have challenges? The answer is yes. What are the challenges? Of course, you have poor network. At times, as we are talking now, I might be on high speed and the network will go off. We have to start again. Poor network, security can be an issue. National infrastructure, especially for those of us in Nigeria. I remember vividly when I was in Germany, I was watching live matches, premiership, from Germany to Italy in a train, all these ICE trains, very fast trains. I was watching the match. No skipping, nothing. Life match. 2-3 in the stadium. Can you imagine? National infrastructure. And I always laugh when they say 5G is coming and some people are fighting it from different angles. You will laugh that what do these people mean? They don't understand. Some people are already on 7G. You are talking about we are fighting 5G. There are some places in Nigeria where they don't even have 2G as we speak. National infrastructure can be a challenge. Now, what are the other things? That those ones are uncontrollable. The controllable ones is power supply. As we speak, I'm on generator because the power supply is off. You understand? So, but you can solve that. Phone limitations. Some people are not in this class. Not because they are not ready, but because their phone is not helpful. Their phone is not helpful. Why? They are limited. You say, I can't download Zoom. I can't download this. And that has been their limitation. Then you have distractions. You have distractions. What are the distractions you have? You see, that's what I need to explain to you. Someone will tell you, I quickly want to check how many presidents have been in Nigeria. That's what you want to check. When you get online, you will see a video. You will run after the video. You will see one WhatsApp message. You will start forwarding. You will see, and you now begin to say that, oh, you don't know what is happening. You must know what is happening. You are the one that is not getting exactly what you should get. Please, I want you to understand that and make sure that you follow what you are supposed to follow very, very adequately. You have to follow it adequately. Do you understand? So what does that mean? That means that you have to understand how to manipulate your way, and that is true self-discipline. True self. So you understand? So you have to discipline yourself when you are online. Stop going to sites that have nothing to do with you. Some of us, why are you on that site? What are you doing on the site? You don't even know. You are just there. You understand? These are things we should reduce as much as possible. Now, another thing we need to understand is our health. That area of health, we need exercise. You need to exercise your body. You need to exercise your body. Look at, as I'm seated here now, what I would have been doing, if it had been in class, I would have been standing. I would not be sitting this way. Are you getting it now? So now that I know that I'll be having long time sitting, my best bet is to ensure that I do much of exercise, exercising my body. Then your eyes. You now spend more time with your phone, with your laptop. You need to use sunshade. Don't tell me your eyes. Some people say, I have very good sight. Nobody has bad sight, but protect what you have. That side that you say is very good, please protect it. And the only way you can protect it is for you to do what? Is for you to have your, to understand what you are supposed to do and to follow it adequately. Do you understand? So that's it about eyes. And then I think that is all as we go to the last part of this class. This is wonderful. I want to give you a few minutes, go through what's on the screen, digital footprint. This is something that we need to check and fully understand. Digital footprint, whenever you go online, you leave behind information about yourself. Can you hear that? Did you see that? Whenever you go online, anytime you go online, you leave information about yourself, even without your knowledge. This is referred to as your digital footprint. Find pictures to represent. Look at this. It shows as if it's showing your leg. You see, as if it's showing your leg, that as you move, your digital footprint, whenever you go online, you leave behind information about yourselves. And that's what we refer to as digital footprint. You can see this. That digital footprint. Now let's go to definition. What is digital footprint? Now by the time you look at the definition, you will appreciate it. Now, the information about a particular person that exists on the internet as a result of their online activity. It is a trail of data you create while using the internet. It includes the websites you visit, emails you send, and information you submit on online services. This is why I give people warning. When it comes to this place, some people will think the website they visit do not matter. They will think, oh, nobody sees it, they cover it. The website you visit, all these information are being collected. Without your knowledge, it's not going away. And information you submit to online services, when you submit information about yourself, you go to a site, they ask you for your name, and you fix your name and the rest. It's there for life. A passive digital footprint is a data trail you unintentionally leave online. You know the funny thing about digital footprint? Some of these things are not what you do intentionally. It's unintentional. The moment you pick up your phone and you do anything online, anything, you type anything, your digital footprint is counting. Are you with me? No, it goes ahead. It is your online identity and individuality. And it's what makes you unique. It builds the online reputation or impression depending on the things you do online. Are you getting something there? It builds your reputation. It is your online identity and individuality. And it's what makes you unique. Do you know something about this? Digital footprint is so powerful. Please, just a minute. Now, you see, when you are going to the embassy and you want to, you need a visa. Oh, do you notice that if you are drop a present, nobody interviews you again? They won't. The reason is that what they are just checking is your digital footprint. Once they check your digital footprint, if it goes well with what they expect, they will give you the visa. If it does not, they won't give you. Then the question is, what is this digital footprint? All the comments you make on social media. By the time someone is writing on WhatsApp, you write back. You abuse the president. You abuse the vice. You abuse your country. You're always negative in everything you write. Oh, you now think nobody sees it. Someone will say, I have deleted it. No, it's not gone. Some people, though they are adults, they are always staying on pornographic sites. You understand? Thinking nobody sees them. By the time someone is coming, they quickly switch it off. They think it's over. It's not over. It's your digital footprint. Comments on social media, Skype calls, application you use, and even all the emails you send. It's part of your online history and can potentially be seen by other people or tracked in a database. Don't deceive yourself thinking that, no, I have wiped up. Someone told me, said, oh, sir, but I flashed my phone. And you didn't flash the database of WhatsApp where you sent all the information. Someone said, but I have cleansed everything. I returned it by factory setting. And now ask, if you ever went to Facebook to clear everything there, do you know that on Facebook, the picture you took 5 years ago, Facebook will bring it to you and tell you memory lane in reminding you. That's the same thing with digital footprint. Everything you ever typed, everything you ever wrote is going to stand against you or stand for you. What's digital footprint? It's your profile on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram. Why you saw my picture so many is because of my digital footprint. My profile on Facebook, my performance on Twitter, what I'm doing on Instagram, Snapchat, LinkedIn, Pinterest, and other mediums, all those things you are doing is going to form your footprint. Photographs of you, which that you or anyone else have posted online, any photograph that have ever been posted of you. That's why I always want people, be careful what you send online. I want people, be careful what you take online. Anything you have written or that has been written about you. For instance, on discussion boards, on WhatsApp pages, on Facebook, on forums, on blogs, or in articles. And that's why you see when I write and you read my article, I always advise my students, please go ahead and say a word, say a comment. When you say a comment, it helps you. The reason why it will help you is that it, because that blog is a positive one, it begins to build your own digital footprint positively. Why is digital footprint important? It is important to be aware of it because anything posted online is permanent. Can someone help me type that? Just type the word permanent. Anything posted online is permanent. And it stays there forever. Permanent forever. Permanent forever. Just give that to me. Anything posted online, anything you ever type online is going to be permanent regardless of being deleted.
regardless of what you do, regardless of how you handle it. Yes, let me read from everybody. I want to be sure you are there. It's permanent and stays forever. It's permanent and stays forever. Yes, permanent. Anything posted online is permanent and it stays there forever. Oh, anything posted online is permanent. Thank you, Engineer Dipo. It's permanent. That stays there forever. Sister Ronke, very grateful. It's permanent. Anything you post online, don't think you can delete it again. Are you getting it now? It's going to be there forever. Thank you, my HOD. It's going to be there forever. Anything posted online, anything ever written on WhatsApp, anything ever written on Facebook, on Twitter, it's going to be there forever, regardless of being deleted on your side. Your digital footprint is often used to obtain your personal information about you. What are the personal information they want to get? Your religion. I have a message. Anything posted online. Thank you, Mrs. Kolawole. I love the capital letter you use in printing that. Your digital footprint is often used to obtain personal information about you, such as demographics, religion, political affiliations, or interests. Information could be gathered using cookies, which are small files, websites stored on your computer after your visit to track user activity. Usually they just use cookies. They gather information about you. That's why I tell people there is a difference between positive criticism and condemnation. When something is going on, don't go there and say, Trump is mad. No, no, no. If you say you shouldn't type such words, vulgar words, you don't type it. Oh, things could have been done better. There are ways of typing it because those things stay there forever. And by the time you are saying you are going to that America, they will now go and check everything you have ever written. By the time they are checking, it will tell us that you are anti-American, so why are you coming to our country? Do you understand? Some people, the way we are going now, you discover that when they have chosen you to be the director of your school, the VC, a director, whatever they have chosen you to be, you discover that by the time they take your digital footprint, they will see what you have written about that same school, what you have said about that same president that you want to work with. And by your digital footprint, you will either be confirmed or you'll be disqualified. That's what we talk about digital footprint. The email you send, are you getting me, goes to your digital footprint. Apart from that, in just a minute, apart from that, posting on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, and other social media. You understand? Filling out online forms, such as when signing up to receive emails or text. If you go to diashobali.com, you are supposed to subscribe. When you subscribe, you are building your digital footprint. But that one is giving you strong digital footprint. Your digital footprint is either positive or negative. You understand? To build a positive digital footprint, you have to go to positive side and intentionally contribute. Agreeing to install cookies. You know, at times most of you don't understand. You wonder, how did they get me? The moment you go online, your laptop, your phone, you understand, they will have gotten the IP, track your number, everything will be saved and stored against your name. You remember that you have registered your line. All these things to be stored and they're saved, and that is where you have gotten. Digital friendship is another thing that is key. It's so germane. When you talk about digital friendship, you begin to see that the people you relate with in the digital world, they matter so much. You understand? The people you relate with in the digital world matter so much, and that will help you in forming your digital friendship. You understand? So by the time you read some of the things, that's why I tell people, be careful who you follow and be careful who you connect. When someone says, I want to be your friend on Facebook, you be very careful. If you are a friend to a criminal, I'm sorry, you might be a criminal. But even if you are not seen as one, if you follow a criminal, then you are a criminal. That's the meaning. So be careful who you follow. If you accept people unconsciously, you cannot follow them unconsciously. So be very careful. Digital footprint, features of digital footprint, if publishing a blog and posting social media, all these ones will help you to be able to have a good digital footprint. You publish a blog. You saw my picture. What brought my picture up to that extent is because of how much I have done in terms of writing on the blog. What are the features of digital footprint? Think before you post. Are you there? Can you write for me? Think before you post. Think before you post. Don't be emotional. When you are annoyed, don't post. When you are angered by someone, don't post. Don't reply someone in anger. Think before you post. Digital footprint. Please think. I'm pleading with you. Think before you post. Don't just post anything. Think before you post. And you must write this. Everybody in the house, I'm expecting you. You must write it. Think before you post. That's the major thing of today's class. You have to think before you post. You don't just go there to post anything. Every picture still lives. Every post never dies. Think before you post. You have to think, meditate, be sure of what you want to say. Have you thought about it? Is it what you really meant? You understand? There are some times when you look at it that they may not get what you are saying. It's better you just stay off and you don't post. You think before you post. Shafel, thank you. Mrs. Konawale, I'm grateful. Mrs. Shrunke, that's good of humor. You understand? You think before you post, before you go online and you start putting your hand in just anything. Some people say, no. I'm going to prove a point. You have no point to prove. You have no battle to win. Post only after you have thought it true. Oyekaji, thank you. True. You must have thought it true. You must have been sure. This is what I meant to write. By the time you call someone foolish, you must be sure you are ready to call him foolish. Some of you, someone you don't know, you have not met before. And the person is going against what you have said. Someone is old enough to be your father. You begin to say you are very foolish. Some of you will be arguing with someone who is younger than your last born at home, all because you don't understand. Don't stay in a group where all they do is to abuse people and you are not being tolerated. No, go to groups where you are celebrated. Brethren, think before you post. You know the reason? Every picture leaves. Every picture still leaves. Every picture still leaves. It's not going to go away. Every picture will still leave. You understand? Because of that reason, you have to think. Because of that reason, you have to think. You have to think before you post. Every picture still lives. Every post never dies. It does not only stop there. This is called your digital footprint. That picture that you have posted, that post that you have sent, is called your digital footprint. The website that you visit. But don't visit website that you cannot show to the world. Don't go and start saying on wrong website. Some people will even go to dating website and put their names there, put their data there. It's very wrong. Everything you have ever put on the internet with your name on it makes up your digital footprint. Your digital footprint and everything in it stays with you and it stays with you forever. So how do we get rid of this footprint? Where do you want to hear some pie? You cannot. You can't get rid of the footprint, but you can keep it clean. Henceforth, how you live your life, how you take your steps, that's the only way you can keep it clean. But for you to say you want to delete it, it's not possible. By the time you check your name on multiple search engines, look at what is written about your name. Apart from that, you should be private on social media. Keep your family to yourself. Your family is not a weekly affair that you throw everywhere. Some people throw, you know, it's so funny. So hospitals have started stopping it now for those they can stop it from. Before even you give birth to a child, you will have snapped the child and sent it on social media. For crying out loud, for what? Without that child's picture, you can't tell people you have given birth. You see, I don't know why we behave like this. What you be, some of you, if you have your way, when you leave the bed, when you are in the bedroom, you will have covered yourself and you'll be posting it on social media. So you should keep private. Social media, sell your product. What you have, you are selling clothes, you are selling goods, you are your intellectual, you sell your products. Let's know who you are. Let's know your worth. Think before you post. It's another thing. Then you build a positive reputation online. These are the things you do to help your digital footprint. So digital footprint, you know what it entails and what it will give you. Your personality will give you presence, digital presence. Your professionalism is going to be built from education, but your potential. Your potential is your strength and experience. Should I tell you something? Your wealth is linked to your strength and not your salary. Your wealth in life, you want to make it in life, it is linked to your strength, not your salary. Thank you. Do you know what that means? That is saying for you to be wealthy, it's your strength, not your salary. So you have to build your strength. You have to know, where am I good at? What's my strength? Your strength, your passion is key. Your passion, you understand? Where am I good at? What is my strength? These are the things you should know. Then you have to pick your passion, because your passion, that is what will determine the height, you see, of how you go. I ask you a question, which I like asking classes. You see, what is the area that you are passionate about? What is the area that you can give anything for? And that is what will help you to determine will help you to identify how far you will go. Your passion is key. You must understand this fact, because that will determine the height of your wealth. Your passion will determine the height of your wealth. How passionate you are, how passionate you are, will make people take you so seriously. We make people know that, no, you are passionate about this. And definitely, if you are passionate about your potential, you are sure of going high in your strength. Are you seeing that combination? Now, apart from that, I have not been able to check area of digital footprint. The second area of digital footprint is the area where you have contributed, is the area where you have moved in life. You understand? I've checked some of you. By the time you look at, we are talking of library in Nigeria. Mrs. Ronke, you are a librarian. When we check library in Nigeria, when we talk about librarians developing library cases, I checked it, your name is not there. You know the reason, because you have not been writing in that regard. And that is another area of digitalization. Of that of footprint. You must pick an area. If you're an educationist, when we talk about developing education among students, I check some of you, your name is not there. You understand? Because you have not been writing in that regard. You must find an area. You begin to blog in that area. When you blog it, you will block that area. When you blog on it, you will block the area. Because people will not know you are the owner of that area. They will know it's your peculiarity. They will know it's your specialty. They will know it's an area that is all your own and nobody can toy with it when you are there. Now, those are the things you have to take note of. I'll give you an example of myself. When I check, I love writing on mentality and reality. By the time I check, look at where it brought my picture. It brought my picture here, just a single picture. That's if you type mentality versus reality now, and you go to images, you will discover that you am the only one that you see his picture as human being, and not all these other ones that are just there. Because I love writing on mentality versus reality. By the time I was going to check at later time, it has brought my picture to this level. Now, by the time I checked it, look at what it has done to my picture. Because it's seeing me. Here, it has treated me as the number one in that regard. Which area have you blocked on? Which area have you blocked? Which area is your own? And that's what we talk about, digital footprint. You must take over. You must take charge. Are you promising me that you will take over your name? Are you promising me that you are going to work on yourself in the digital world? When they talk about you, it is you and you alone. Mentality versus reality. And that is what I've been able to do. I brought on the issue of digitalization. It still brought my picture, but it did not bring it high up, because I've not written much in that regard. And definitely, I'm not stopping. I will keep writing in that regard. Now, another issue is you block your name. You see this? I've shown you before. Can you see what I've done? I've taken over my name. I've taken over completely. You block your name. Block your name. Don't allow. Take over your name. Yeah, can someone type take over? Can I see? Can you promise him? Can you promise me? Are you promising me? Give me a promise. Write it there. I'm taking over my name. I want to see you write that. I'm taking over my name. You understand? It's something you need to do, because once you take over your name, that time when they now type your name, it's you and you alone. Because there's only one you. You understand? And you have to be effective in the digital world for you to, yes, I'm taking over my name. Ms. Kolaole, I appreciate that. I want to see you write it. I'm taking over. Raphael, that's wonderful. I'm taking over my name. It's my name in the digital world. I'm taking over. It's going to be me and me alone. As far as Onyekachi, I believe you make up this promise. And how do you do this? When you do this, thank you, Mrs. Ronke. When you do this, you discover through your blogs, you can be doing it. And there's another final thing you need to understand, and that is digital immortality. Do you want to hear the truth? We are going to live digitally forever. You want me to prove it? Digital immortality. You can see this Martin Luther King. You see this woman. I brought her because she's not a politician. You understand? And she's still there. You type her name, you bring her picture out. Nelson Mandela. We are going to live forever. That's it, digitally. Even after we are gone, the question is, what picture are we showing about you? That's the question you need to understand. When your great-grandchild wants to check, they once told them that you lived, and they want to check about your profile. Is there anything for them to check? Digital immortality. You have to work on yourself. You have to get involved in this digital world. You can't be afford to be quiet. You see Shagari there. Digital immortality. You see Aolowo. Digital immortality. Our wonderful friend, Abba Kyari, you can see him there. You understand? That's digital immortality. I've shown you so that you can know. Thank you so much, my children. So that you can know that you owe yourself a lot of determination. You have to decide today, I am going digital. There is nothing. And how do you do it? It's a sacrifice. Create uniqueness. What's your name? Dr. Tayo. It's a good name. If you are going to pick it up like that, you pick up your engineer. It's a very good name. You understand? Unique name. Create uniqueness. Digital profession. What are you going to be doing in the digital world? As you know your profession, you know your specialty, then you know those you go friendship with. What I will give you as assignment or an advice is get online. Go and read www.ashobari.com. Make a comment. Excuse me. Make a comment. When you make a comment, you see things will work out well. Now, digital investment and sacrifice. I will advise you, build a blog for yourself. www.yourname.com is just 50,000 for yourself. You can't hide it. You can't hide from it. Yes. Oh, thank you so much. So just go and read that. So you need a blog for yourself with some designs and maintenance. If you have a business, I don't think anybody has business that is doing privately here. But if you have a business, with 30K, you need a website. So once that is done, the next thing is digital growth. Now, you are not going to stop there. We are going to have, I should be putting a 19th here. We are having another fundamental class that will be coming up on Friday 19th. That's of June, this Friday, by 8 p.m. The fee is 25. If you have enjoyed this class, please tell someone else about it. You understand? Because you understand. Tell someone, let me know, and let me know if you